Joining us with markets is Chuck Shelby, Risk Management Commodities. Chuck, let's talk about the fact that we are in that time of year where we're in a weather market in the grain trade. Things can get kind of volatile. So what is your marketing advice for producers so they don't get chopped up?
It's certainly one of the more difficult times to make decisions and to really, you know, hone in on why that is. Where these prices are, which is basically near or slightly above the cost of production for many producers, it'd be a lot easier for producers to sell if we had $13 or $14 beans and, you know, $5.50 or $6 corn. So it's really challenging here, especially for producers who have maybe a late planted crop or struggling with no rain. So at this point in time, I think we got to take advantage of the opportunities, get something sold, you know, be flexible on how you do it. You can sell cash and have some call options. You can look at put options. But in a time when there's a lot of uncertainty, it forces producers, I think, to take a look and try to make some decisions based upon, the tools that are available to them.
No doubt. I know you also watch seasonals. And what do those say? Because sometimes in a weather market, we can top before you have the worst of the news in the market, right?
Yeah, I think the seasonals tend to peak out here at the end of June, definitely a lot of times around the 4th of July. So this is a time window when there's an opportunity for producers, even though it may not feel like it.
And even when you get those pops in a weather market, they can be really fleeting, can't they?
You look what the wheat did. We had a massive rally in wheat, and, you know, look how far down we've come. You look at the hog market, major rally. And what have we done? We've reversed thrusters and come all the way back down to, where the market started last winter. So it just seems like we need to take advantage of a rally if it occurs. These aren't markets that seem to want to stay with these kind of rallies. I think that goes back to the, two conflicts going on in the world and a lot of, things out there that aren't positive for, really good demand.
Some good advice as always. Thanks so much, Chuck Shelby, Risk Management Commodities. We'll have more AgDay coming up.
Watch Markets Now with Michelle Rook on the Farm Journal YouTube channel, keeping you updated throughout the day on the markets at the open, midday, and close. Find out what moved the markets today and what to expect the market to do next.